My dad often tells the story of a time long, long ago, before computers, iPads, and Google in schools. The story is about a young boy. It has to be said, Paul was not the most engaged student. As Miss Pushy was talking to the class, all Paul wanted to do was play cricket. Miss Pushy continued, explaining to her class this term's project was to write a picture book. Paul started thinking about something to write about. He remembered Miss Pushy telling him he had a wonderful imagination. Surely he could come up with something. Paul thought and thought and thought. Maybe a cat? No, I don't even like cats, he said to himself. Then an idea came to him. What about a purple sleeping bag? And when kids come over to stay at the house, the purple sleeping bag comes alive and eats them all. Paul's imagination took him on many adventures, some a little disturbing. That's it. That's an awesome idea, Paul said to himself. Paul started working on his story. The ideas flowed and flowed. Not even his best friend Roger could distract him from the purple sleeping bag story. Paul was on a mission. What will Miss Pushy think? I hope she likes it, Paul thought. Not yet, Paul. It's good, but you can make it better. Paul got back to work. Miss Pushy asked lots and lots of questions that made Paul think of more and more ideas. Miss Pushy suggested he write it up a little neater, draw some pictures to go with the story, and display it in the library for other students to enjoy. Paul became worried. He didn't want other people to read his story. What if they don't like it? He thought to himself. But Paul was feeling rather brave on this particular day and said, okay. A couple of days later, Paul's favourite part of the day arrived. Lunchtime. Time for cricket with his friends. He ran as fast as he could, but as he ran, he heard something rather disturbing. Rain. As the rain poured down, he noticed the library, a place he rarely visited. As he walked past the books, he heard some giggling. Three girls were sitting around a table, chatting and flickering through the books. One girl broke away from the other two and walked toward the purple sleeping bag story. No, don't! Paul screamed inside his head. The girl picked up Paul's story and began reading. What if she hated it? But she didn't hate it. She loved it. She placed the book back on the table and walked away giggling. Just then, another girl picked up the purple sleeping bag. She too loved the story. Paul's heart felt truly warm, a feeling he had never felt before. While this was all happening, Miss Pushy sat in the corner of the library watching intently. She smiled and smiled again, content that she had encouraged Paul to write a story he was proud of. Like most teachers, she was unaware of the impact her actions would have on this young boy. But her actions did make a difference. Great teachers make a difference.